First of all, I want to thank the mayor, his honor, and members of the council for allowing me to come and talk to you a little bit about the restoration of our Tree Sheboygan project and perhaps related to some of the things we are trying to do with the city and throughout the county here. I'll give you a presentation for perhaps 10 or 12 minutes, and then I'll open it to questions. If any of the members of the council or others have questions, we'll try to address them. I am not an arborist, but fortunately, Tim Bull, your city forester, is here and can deal with the technical questions, I would assume. And before I get started, I also want to introduce Scott Litke, who is the president of the Sheboygan Rotary Club, and along with a number of other Rotarians, has been instrumental in helping me put this project together and getting it off the ground. Essentially, this project that I'm speaking to tonight and the benefits for the city started about 2 years ago when the Sheboygan Rotary Club and a second Rotary Club in Sheboygan, the so-called Early Birds Rotary Club, came together to work with Joe Curlin, your superintendent of parks, with regard to trying to do some planting with the city. And I got put in a committee and was introduced to the scope of an environmental problem that I knew existed, but I don't think I appreciate it fully, and that is the infestation of the emerald ash borer, which I'm sure this body is generally quite familiar with at this point. I worked with Joe and the public works staff and the park staff over a period of time. The two Rotary Clubs raised resources that weren't available to the city to plant a total of about 140 trees, and that was in celebration of the city's 40th anniversary of it being the Tree City USA and the oldest city in the state that had had that remarkable honor bestowed upon it. So we were able to raise $14,500 to assist the city in planting 140 trees in parks and on the streets here in the city of Sheboygan. But during that period of time, Joe Curlin and the city staff really educated me to the scope of the emerald ash borer problem and the devastation it was presenting to the city of Sheboygan and obviously well beyond the city itself throughout the county. And at one or two points during our meeting, I asked Joe whether the city was alone in this effort. Obviously, there's some county involvement and state involvement. And I asked whether the private sector was at all engaged in this effort to try to deal with this environmental threat. And the answer, quite frankly, is the city was pretty much by itself, along with some county and state help, but that the private sector wasn't stepping up to the plate at that point. And it seemed to me as a Rotarian that Rotary can play a role here in helping not only the city of Sheboygan, but communities throughout the area in trying to bring forward private resources that weren't then being presented. Now, I'm old enough, probably older than most of you in this room, to remember the Dutch elm disease of the 1950s and 1960s. That devastated what had been the city of elms. The city of Sheboygan was known as the city of elms by, of course, a destruction of many of the beautiful elm trees that we had. But the response to that was not just a city or a county response at that time, it was a response involving the private sector as well. And it seemed to me that it was time for someone to stand up and to be supportive of what the municipality here in Sheboygan and those municipalities elsewhere in the county were doing. So I was able to prevail on the Rotary Club in Sheboygan to allow me to go forward and put together a project that eventually came to be known as Restoration of Our Trees Sheboygan, or ROOTS. You have to have an acronym for what you're doing, and we began the process of working with an environmental organization, a network, if you would, in eastern part of Wisconsin that is known as the Lakeshore Natural Resource Partnership, which is already working with the city on a number of other projects. But we came together and formed an MOU in partnership with LNRP to try to put together a strategy that we thought might make a difference in helping not only this municipality, but others throughout the county. So over the period of the late part of 2018 and early 2019, we put an MOU together with LNRP, And there were three legs to it, and I'm going to principally look at one of those with you, one part of our strategy this evening, which impacts on the city, but there were three aspects of it. First of all, we wanted to get out and do some public education. The city certainly and the county were doing some things, but this really isn't your role, it seems to me, in terms of public education and public outreach. So we got together and worked with the Maywood Environmental Center and some other educational institutions in the area to try to begin to educate the public overall as to this environmental threat. We've done that in some workshops we've run through Maywood. We hope to do some more with the public education system here throughout the county. Frankly, we're being slowed in the effort right now because of the COVID-19 and the inability to get people together, but we're trying to do more virtually on that. But that was one part of our strategy. The second part was we realized that there was an absence of resources to do forest management and forestry planning. Now, we're well along because of Tim and Joe and the others here in the city with that process in the city of Sheboygan. And the larger municipalities in the county are well along as well because there's some resources there and expertise. Where we're not doing very well is in the townships. And so the Department of Natural Resources in the end of 2018 awarded us a modest grant to begin to work actively with the townships throughout the county. And we are now well along in that process. We're using volunteers. We're using technical expertise from LNRP and also from the DNR in order to work with the townships to begin to build a database and to begin to collect data on the resources, principally ash resources that are out there and that will be lost to this devastation. I didn't mention it earlier, but just to give you a scope of what we're up against here, probably on the order of over one-third of the street and park trees in Sheboygan are ash, and they'll all be lost to this EAB infestation before we're done. In the next 5 or 10 years, you'll lose it all. So as you all go home tonight, take a look at the tree canopy and realize that about one out of every three of those trees you see is an ash and it's about to be lost. That's why something needs to be done about this if we're going to preserve the canopy. And overall in the county, over 17 million trees are ash trees. Some townships, like the town of Sheboygan, for example, the percentage of ash is much higher. It's as high as 70% ash in the town of Sheboygan. And if you drive into that area, think about what that's going to look like in 5 or 10 years. So the second leg in this effort then was to bring some resources into this for actual planning. And as I said, that process is underway. Again, COVID-19 has made it somewhat complicated to train our volunteers and get them out there. I talked to the DNR within the last couple of hours and their understanding of the challenges that COVID is representing to us, but they've been very accommodating, allowing us to go forward. They renewed and extended that grant this past year, and we're now up to a grant of about $50,000 that is being used for urban forestry planning. But the real element to the strategy that I wanted to address with you this evening is what we call our Community Investment Fund, which is a fund that seeks private capital from industry, from business, and from large foundations that have the means to do so, that go into the Sheboygan County Rotary Foundation, a 501c3 organization, that then we're going to make available and are making available to municipalities here in Sheboygan on a matching basis in order to accelerate the level of replanting of trees and the removal of ash trees that, of course, are a part of the problem here. We're well along in that process. We've raised resources both from the public sector. The U.S. Forest Service a year ago granted us $200,000 for Sheboygan County that is essentially focused on mitigation of emerald ash borer. And we're the only county in all of Wisconsin right now that has had the benefit of that large grant coming to us. So it's a unique thing. It's happened because of what Roots is doing. And some of that $200,000 resources will be made available to the city of Sheboygan and to municipalities. We've already dedicated some of those resources to mitigation in the Esslingen Park that you're familiar with just west of the city. Gerber Lake out in the neighborhood of Lakeland University and the Sheboygan Marsh, which is almost exclusively ash. So the mitigation there will be underway, and by mitigation I mean the removal of ash trees and the planting of non-ash replacement trees. Again, COVID-19 has slowed up our ability to bring in some of the contractors that we want to, but we're at least in the stage where we will dedicate those resources. Specifically this evening, and there's a resolution you'll be voting on later, the other aspect of our third level of strategy, or a third leg here, is the private money that we have raised in the Sheboygan area. It's still a modest amount, but it's enough for us to go forward with 5 demonstrator projects. 2 of those projects involve the city of Sheboygan, and we're hoping that you will allow us to move forward with the adoption of a resolution a little bit later this evening. Each of the Sheboygan-based Rotary Clubs is offering resources to the city of Sheboygan. The Roots Fund itself, which offers additional Rotary resources, will be available for 2 sets of projects. And then we have the assistance of the Alliant Energy Company that is making a corporate donation of about $5,000 to further support this effort. So what we're bringing to the city, and with a lot of help from Tim and from Joe Curlin, who helped put the plan together, are 2 separate mitigation plans involving a total of 6 city parks. It will accelerate mitigation in Lakeview Park, you're familiar with that, on the south side of Sheboygan, the Rotary Park right down along the water area itself, and Area 5 of the Evergreen Park, which of course gets tremendous use on the part of many in the community for recreational purposes, public meetings. That work will be done with the support of the Sheboygan Rotary Club and the Alliant Energy Company, and also with a district grant from the Rotary organization. And 3 additional parks then will be supported in a mitigation effort by the Early Bird Rotary Club. That'll be Roosevelt Park, Cleveland Park, and Veterans Park. And they're also going to be part of the effort on Area 5 of Evergreen Park. So all told, we're stepping up to the plate to work with the city of Sheboygan to accelerate mitigation in those 6 parks. I want to tell all of you that you've got a tremendous staff here. If you don't already know it, you probably do, with Joe Curlin and Tim Bull, who have been instrumental in putting these projects together. They've been highly responsive, and I can't say enough for the city staff and the cooperation we've had. I won't go into the details of the other 3 projects, but just I'll cover them very quickly and say that we've got 1 project going with the city of Sheboygan Falls to mitigate in the so-called River Park area, if you're familiar with that, and a access point to River Park. We'll be doing that project, and the County Stewardship Fund has come forward to help the Rotary organization assist in funding the city of Sheboygan Falls in that project. We also have approval now to go forward with a project for 4 parks and mitigation of 4 parks in Plymouth. That again is being done with the assistance of the Plymouth Utilities Organization, and again with Rotary District money and with Rotary money we brought to this effort through Roots. So that project will go forward later this summer. And finally, we're out and working with the Village of Elkhart Lake and a modest program out there involving 2 parks and a number of street areas. So all told, we have a lot going on with these demonstrator projects. I would simply, before I open myself to questions, I would ask for the council members that are here present tonight and those that are, of course, virtually with us, if we could look for your support, first of all, for the resolution tonight, and secondly, as Roots goes forward, we're going to be continuing to knock on private sector doors, corporate Sheboygan County, and also large foundations with means, so that we can, if you would, if I may use an old Navy term, I'm a naval officer of 23 years, retired, to use an old Navy term, we are really trying to get all hands on deck here for a whole of community effort to combat this problem. We believe the council knows it's a problem, and I know you've dedicated additional resources to the public works staff and the park staff. We would ask you to continue supplementing that support, which is going to be necessary in the next several years when the devastation becomes ever more apparent. And while you do that, Roots and the private sector will step up to the plate, but anything you can do to help us raise money in the private sector would be would be greatly welcomed as we go forward. We hope to have a project that really winds itself up in another 2 to 3 years. We want to make an impact, to use an old military term of mine. I'm calling this a surge effort. You've heard about the surge in Afghanistan and Iraq. Well, this is a surge for Sheboygan County, but it's in an environmental war that we're engaged in. We want to put resources on this problem quickly. We want to do this for future generations. I don't have to tell you that it makes a difference in terms of not so much those of us who are present tonight, but our children and our grandchildren who will enjoy this tree canopy if we can maintain it. The advantages are tremendous. Aesthetically, it's an advantage. Offers, of course, the city of Sheboygan benefits in terms of its tax base, quite frankly, because it's a demonstrated fact that tree canopies help with property values, public and private. And the other thing I guess I would point out is that it obviously helps with the effort of global warming, removes CO2 from the air, and obviously pollutants as well. So there are many benefits to maintaining a healthy tree canopy, economic, ecological, and otherwise. With that, Mr. Mayor and members of the council, thank you for your time and attention, and I'll